The Hollywood Awards season kicked off last night with the Golden Globes awarded by the Foreign Press Association. And although they honor movies and TV, for now, we're just sticking with their top film awards. For Best Drama, 12 Years a Slave. For Best Comedy, American Hustle. And for Acting in a Drama, Matthew McConaughey for Dallas Buyers Club and Kate Blanchett for Blue Jasmine. For Acting in a Comedy, Leonardo DiCaprio for The Wolf of Wall Street and Amy Adams for American Hustle. ABC's entertainment editor, Leslie Messer, joins us now. Good morning, Leslie.
Good morning.
Okay, so what was the biggest surprise of last night?
Nobody expected Matthew McConaughey to take home Best Actor. He was wonderful in Dallas Buyers Club.
Yeah.
Obviously, the film has been critically beloved, but this is supposed to be Chiwetel Ejiofor's year. Everyone was sure he was a shoo-in. So it was interesting to see someone else's name get called tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. And there were a few other surprises, people really not expecting to be the winner, not having acceptance speeches prepared. Talk to me about some of the best of those.
Amy Poehler, when Amy Poehler's name was called for her role in Parks and Recreation and Andy Samberg for Brooklyn Nine-Nine, they were so surprised to hear their names called that their speeches were adorable, off the cuff, just so sort of teeming with happiness. It was a wonderful moments in last night's award show.
Yeah, so genuine. You could tell they really were surprised.
And excited. I think that so many times in award shows, you see people give the same old tired speech. It's nice to see excitement and spontaneity up on stage.
But there was also some spontaneity that maybe didn't come across the same way as that. And one of those examples is Jacqueline Bisset's acceptance speech.
I think that made everyone a little uncomfortable. She started with some stunned silence, and then when she did talk, it was a little rambling. She gave some beauty advice at one point. Obviously, she cursed on stage.
And they didn't quite bleep her at the right moment.
Right. The censors were maybe sleeping a little, but it did give us all something to talk about. So there's that.
This is true. And something else that people are talking about is the opening monologue and just what an awesome job the host did.
I want them to host everything going forward.
Yes.
Amy Poehler and Tina Fey have such chemistry. They're so funny. And they're the kind of women that you want to see more of because they're smart, they're not mean. They have a great time, and I think it comes through.
And you know, they kind of poked at the audience a little bit, but like you said, it wasn't mean, it got the whole crowd involved, everyone laughing.
Right, and the people that they were talking about didn't want to crawl in a hole. They could laugh at themselves, which was great.
Right, okay, and so now we know all of the big winners from this first night of the award season. What does this mean for the Oscars?
It shows that it's anybody's game. Obviously, the Hollywood Foreign Press loves some movies that maybe Oscar doesn't, but 12 Years a Slave, American Hustle both came up big tonight. Obviously, we saw Matthew McConaughey pull out a surprise win, so it's anybody's game. I can't wait to see what happens.
All right, ABC Entertainment Editor Leslie Messer, thanks so much for joining us this morning, and we will be right back.